my people, the Princess Buttercup.
What's interesting is that the Princess Bride almost starts where most fairy tales end. The commoner becomes a princess and is engaged to a prince. That's where most fairy tales end. And that's what's fascinating about it. It takes the tradition of fairy tales and almost turns it on its head by beginning at the ending.
When Buttercup moves past her initial social positioning into the role of a princess, she sees how empty it really is and how much more valuable that idea of love, of connection can be. It's really a turning point for her in many ways.
Buttercup's emptiness consumed her. Although the law of the land gave Humperdinck the right to choose his bride, she did not love him.
Buttercup may seem like a typical princess at first when she accepts the fate that Humperdinck has thrust upon her.
But the one thing she still can do is ride her horse.
The only joy she found was in her daily ride.
And horses are traditionally in literature a symbol of freedom. Freedom, power, sexual freedom too. Horses tend to be, you know how little girls often go through a horse phase, and that tends to be just prepubescent. And it seems, so by giving Buttercup that freedom of the horse, there's already a signal that she's not just gonna be a helpless young woman.